You know, just for the fun of it, I think I'm gonna, because it's Valentine's Day and Mardi Gras too, I'm gonna put on some Mardi Gras beads, a couple of pair of them, and take my walking stick, and me and Okiwan Kenobi, our assistant DJ who helps the Universal DJ all the way, who really is the Universal DJ, I just assume his role as a human being, okay? So he and I are kind of like, you know, cosmic friends, cosmic bros and shit like that. I call him my little big man, you know, kind of as a pun onto the little big man book and movie way back when, starring Dustin Hoffman and Chief Dan George. What an awesome movie. If you haven't seen that one in a while, it's time to revisit it, isn't it? I tell you, that's a great one. I hope you can find it for free on YouTube or wherever, you know. If you got to pay for it, it's worth it, man. You know, that is classic, and it's beautiful. Considering Standing Rock and everything of these days, it's beautiful because it's about being multicultural and liberal and open and free and living a real life, don't you see, and not following the plan of anybody else, man. Just going with the flow of your heart, don't you know, and living and growing and being a human being. That's an awesome thing to be, don't you see? I thought you'd see it my way, because, you know, my way or the highway, baby, and the highway is my way, okay? So, you know, whatever way you go, you're going my way. I should play that Frank Sinatra. Whoops, I almost spilled coffee on my beautiful little computerized machine here to broadcast our Spring Creek Medicine Show right to your heart, don't you know? From here at 9,000 feet high in the Rocky Mountain sky. Yes, indeed, here on the Hazy Radio Network, you got Grandpa Koyote and a whole raft of angelic friends, including our Okiwan Kenobi, man. You know, isn't that awesome, man? Just, aren't you glad you're tuning in? And we're so glad to have you here with our live and spontaneous tunage. You know, we got the largest green room there ever could be. Johnny Carson's really jealous, don't you? Well, he's actually here, too. We got everybody in our green room. It's rock and roll heaven, man, up here at 9,000 feet high in the Rocky Mountain sky. You betcha, you know. All we got to do is call it. There they are, man, you know. And they all of them want to perform here because, you know, it's fun to help people get it clear. And that's what they were doing here in the first place, don't you know, dear? You know, with all their medicine shows out there on the road, as well as all this really awesome recorded stuff too that we're playing back to you day after day in that spontaneous sort of way. You see, their heart, your heart, we all communicate together, bring forward just the right tunage to move you in just the right direction, get you giggling at just the right time, your ass shaking at the other time, and maybe you can get you do them together, man. Wow, you're multicultural, man. You thought I was going to say multifaceted, didn't you? Well, you're multi-directional, omnidirectional. You go out in all directions when you go off, baby. Just like that explosion we was talking about the other day. That explosion of, the white hot consciousness of truth, man. Coming your way in a tsunami of love today. Because it's Valentine's Day. So that's why I think I might just go down there today. And me and Oki take a little stroll down there to that little medicine show they call the Ziggurat down below, man. It's this monument. It sits up on a little sandy hill. You know, I'm kind of in line with it out my open door here from the spaceship love, but it's like 3 miles down the hill or 2 miles down the hill, something like that. See, Oki's ready to go right now. He says, let's get into flow. Let's go, man, go. Hey, Oki, we're on the show, man. You got some medicine for us, don't you know? I thought so. Anywho, that's where we're going to go here in just a little while. We'll take our walk and stick in some, like I said, some Mardi Gras beads because, you know, we're probably going to meet some real friendly spirits along the way because you usually do. I mean, even though it's isolated and desolated and it's out there all by itself, that ziggurat thing on top of that hill. Well, you know, like I said, there's spirits and energies all over the place, you know. Might just come and, you know, dance a happy dance with Grandpa and Oki while we're down there. You just never know what kind of flow you're going to get in this here medicine show of life, don't you know? All I know is it's time. I ain't been down here for a little while. It's just time to go pay a little visit, and it's kind of a pleasant day out there. I'm going to have to walk a little way because it's going to be a big old mud hole down there I won't drive through. But that's okay, you know. Me and Oki just lock it up and walk on up the hill, man, you know. It's a shame you have to lock it up. Never used to, but, you know, nowadays there's, you know, a few desperate people around that, I don't know what they'd want to steal out of my car, but you know, well, I mean, just slow them down a little bit anyway. Nah, we leave the angels there to guard it. It's all okay. You know, I've actually left my car. Well, I can't say that on the air, though, because then somebody will say, oh, okay, he does that, does he? Oh, I'm just kidding you around, just like I was a few minutes ago about Santa Barbara, don't you know? We're just having a great time here on this Mardi Gras Valentine's Day. You know, helping each other party away and, you know, plan away too, man, for a really auspicious opening today, because I feel it underway, don't you? Yeah, you know, I mean, it's a love day, man. It's a day of uniting. It's a day we celebrate, you know, our more romantic inclinations, etc., you know. But my romance, as is always, with life. I'm telling you, I married Mary Jane, and she married me when I was like 5 years old, man. I'm, well, you know, kind of, sort of, but yeah, for real, too. See, there's this little gal in my Sunday school class called Mary Jane, you know, and she really liked me, and she liked to help me along the way, and we liked to talk, man. You know, we were really, you know, we could communicate with one another as little five-year-old kids, man. Rocking down, you know, seeing each other eye to eye. And one Sunday, we realized that, gee whiz, you know, we were like married already, so we better go, you know, home and introduce her to my parents and get their blessing so we can get married and move in together and have our own little house and shit. Or maybe still live at my place, but whatever, you know. We were getting married, man. We were talking about the dynamics of the arrangement and everything. You know, arm in arm, and, you know, we wrapped our little arms around each other, you know, our little waist, and walked home like that. God, it was so cute, man. I can still remember the feeling of it, too. I was, like, dead earnest, and so was she. We didn't know any different, you know. We thought that'd be the coolest thing, that we thought people would be overjoyed to hear about, you know, Mary Jane and me wanting to hook up. Of course, you know. Well, gosh, when we got home, man, all arm in arm still, man, you know. Well, we got home, and there's, you know, my brothers and sisters hearing us talking about getting married, you know, and deadly earnest about it. And they're just laughing and rolling on the floor, and Mom and Dad can't keep a straight face. And, you know, it's just like, we were a bit humiliated that nobody would take us serious, man. But I'm telling you, since that day, I've been married to Mary J, even though I didn't do it with my parents' approval. Who needs the parents' approval? Screw them, man. We eloped, man, right there in that moment of time. We eloped into each other's heart, man. And even though we never grew up and got married in the physical reality, we sure had a great time that day. And we've been united ever since. It's just, you know, symbology is everything in this life. And that was, you know, dictating from my little innocent five-year-old self what would be my future presence and what would be my true romance in this whole life. So Mary Jane's always been my Valentine ever since then. I'm glad she came to me in the person of that presence too. I really like that Mary Jane. I really do. It's too bad we didn't grow up and, you know, wind up moving in together and all that stuff. But, you know, she had to go another way. And me, I was just too damned independent to play, you know. It's one of those taxi moments, you know. Harry, keep the change. And I would, too. I saw her, like, the girl now that personified Mary Jane back then. Ah, sometime in my 30s, I'd done a wild thing, and I'd got an illness out there on the highway that I had to deal with at home. So I went to this, went back to my old hometown to a kid I knew that was now a doctor, a kid I went to school with that was now a doctor. I figured he'd treat me right, keep his mouth shut about what was happening and stuff like that. And so it was a cool situation, but I had to go there, and odd as it would seem, that's when I ran into Mary J, because she was there too, you know. But boy, she was a whole different person now than she was at 5 years old. And I sent a lot of my heart feelings her way, because I could tell she wasn't very happy, man. She had a life, you know, the fancy furs and all that, but you could tell it was one of those lion eyes kind of things, man. Not that she ever would, but, you know, she just got herself into that. Life is like that. It's a doggone melodrama for most of us, you know. And man, it's, I mean, I pray every day I don't run into anybody from my childhood, because most of the time the turnout isn't what you ever thought it would be. You know what I mean? Sometimes it is. There was another time I met another little gal, but she wasn't Mary Jane. We never had no romance or nothing ever, but she was a buddy of mine when I was a kid. She was always sweet on me, and I was always kind of sweet on her. She grew up the tracks from me there just a little ways. Her mama was a school teacher. Anyway, long story short, I ran into her when we were both about 40 maybe, you know, in this little town in Utah. She just happened to be visiting as I was, you know, but we just had a moment and then we're on our way. But she was really awesome. That was one I really was proud of how she turned out. She was a big timer back in Washington, D.C., you know, our favorite city, eh? But she was really doing all right and looking good and doing okay, man. You know, she'd ripened into a really beautiful blossom of a woman in her middle ages, and I'm sure she still is too to this day, because I knew she could hold it. I won't say her name, but she knows who she is, and I got a sneaking suspicion she might be tuned in out there today. And if you are, baby, well, here's to your Valentine too. I love you so much, and thanks for being so kind to me when we met in those days back then, man. God, that must have been 30 years ago now, yeah. Crazy how time flies. The older you get, the faster it goes, kids. But well, for all of us these days, the time just ain't holding still. But I'm glad I've had the steadiness of Mary Jane's love in me ever since I was 5 years old. Actually, before that, but that was when, you know, in a comical sort of way, I think the angels engineered that thing right to this very day. I think that they just brought that whole thing into being, just so at some heart level place where I probably wouldn't remember for a long time, they just hook me up with that energy and remind me of what I was all about, you know, that I was mama's boy and then some, you know, not in that old softy sort of way, but in the way that mama wanted me to come out and play every day. She wanted the best of everything for me. I was a mama's boy, you know, and still am, man, because Mary J. is my mama and my old lady too, man, my partner for ever and ever, you know. If you know what I mean, Jelly Bean, see? I live with her inside, you know, and she lives with me. And we're perfectly naturally joined, and just like us and the earth are. See, that's who she be, is the earth. And I'm her old man, you know. I mean, you know, in my microcosmic little life, that's the way it is. In your life, it's, you know, a similar thing, though you may feel it a little differently. It's the same thing, really. Each one of us are that. We're the molecule at the center of creation. That, you know, we're little particles that decided to join in an intelligent form and create a life that we could feel. That's who me and Mary J. are. That's who you are inside of yourself too, see? Each one of us has that. That's our Valentine. That's our heart. It's a unity thing, see? And it's never alone, and it's never desperate for love. Not ever. It never surrenders itself and gets wounded. Ever. I mean, you know, it's not vulnerable like that. You know, it's just love. Pure, simple, innocent love. A unified heart. You know, it might have two sides to it, but there's no division between those sides. I mean, the two sides are the one side. It's one heart. They're not two sides. It's all in the way you look at it. It's all in the way you be it. See? That's what it's all about. So yeah, it's a metaphorical thing, the little story about me and Mary J. at 5 years old, wouldn't you say? And she really unioned with me greatly when I was about 19 years old and finally wise enough to encounter something like that and use it in a way or employ it in a way that I wouldn't get in trouble with the law, because it was very illegal in its day, you know. But I was already her papal presence then when I was 19, when she came and encountered me in that sacred herbal form, man, you know. And again, brought to me by a sweetheart, but not a lover, a real sweetheart, a lover of a different sort. You know, there's all kinds of levels of love and all kinds of levels of connection. And they're all deep and powerful if you just allow them to be. A simple friendship can sometimes be more dynamic and powerful in that loving sort of way than the greatest lover you ever had, ever slept with, ever knew. You know what I mean, Jelly Bean? It goes all kinds of different ways here, you know. We've been taught to focus on one certain area and consider that to be love and romance, but it's not true. It's just one little aspect of it. You know, it can be quite awesome and dynamic, but it can also be very imprisoning too, right? We all know that feeling, don't we? That the day we wake up and realize and say to ourselves, oh my God, what have I done? You know, when you realize that, you know, by chasing that dream, you've actually brought yourself to a point where you're stuck now. And even though you love this person and you love the kids and you love your home and your hometown and all that shit, you realize at some point that you disempowered yourself by chasing that kind of love. That you became hornswoggled and became a slave in a system that just wants to eat you alive. And your children too. It don't want nobody to be free. It wants them to go through the same damn thing you do. You know, and sometimes parents just impose that on the kids thinking, that's justice. I gotta suffer, you do too, you little brat. Not very fair to the kids, but it happens that way sometimes, don't it? Sometimes parents can be an awful burden, you know. But in the long run, you know, no matter how bad it's been, you'll see it as a blessing. Just like, you know, these little moments I talk about in my life, so that you can reiterate in your life the little moments too that brought life through you. You know, we have a common presence here that goes through very similar experiences, though each in their own unique and personal way. That's what makes it so beautiful, and that's why we come here to play, because you get it personal life here. And it's your own little avenue, whatever the hell that is, for a little while. It's a rare feeling in this reality, man. It really is, you know, because everything else around us thinks and acts as a collective. And in fact, we do too. But we just chose to experience it in an isolated way for a while, because we didn't know what that was, you know what I mean? Boy, we got the hang of that, didn't we? Holy shit. Talk about disempowerment. And then a re-empowerment by realizing the futility of trying to fulfill it in any other way than the heart's own presence inside of yourself. In other words, realize the first love is the only love you have, and that's who you are, and that's what you are right now in this presence of time, in this moment of person. It's your own personality coming forward, yes. Your own personal path, yes. Deeply appreciated by the heart of the collective inside of you, which lives every little moment of it with you, through you, as you do with everyone else too. You'll soon realize that as you allow your feelings to grow and extend romantically into this reality around you. You know, it's a feeling thing, and it's based on the energy of love, because that's what everything's made of, including us. And so now, in this Valentine's Mardi Gras day, man, in a Mardi Gras sort of way, we're setting ourselves free to party in the life that we're living. In other words, to feel every little particle of its presence within and all about us, and celebrate that presence in ourselves first and foremost. And then we got a blossoming thing to share everywhere and with everyone. So as I go walk up that little spiraling pathway to the top of the ziggurat today, I'm going to be carrying the energy of all you with me too, and we're going to do a joining up there today in the realities of love and truth and understanding. You know what I mean, Jelly Bean? It's just an energy thing, a small little moment. It's personal for you and I and the rest of us too, all of us that fly, you know, but it's just one little bean doing one little thing along with his one little bean of a dog, you know what I mean? I'm not inviting anybody else along, yet everybody will be there, and we're just going to have a little moment, aren't we? And if I don't do it today, if the weather blows me away, well, I'll do it tomorrow then, won't I? But I think today's the day. I think the sun's coming out, and yeah, we got a little bit of a hazy blue sky out there today. Going to be pleasant enough to do it, so we'll perform that little ritual just for you, and it's not really a ritual, yet it is. It's got a certain energy and a pattern to it. It's called, you know, awakening, opening, the dynamic of gateway, you see, you know, just celebrating that a little bit for a moment, a brief moment, just in a symbolic sort of way. But the symbology is great, and it's all kinds of fun. The spiral of the ziggurat is the spiral of life, ever going upwards, ever ascending. And really, once you get to a certain point, the top of the ziggurat, you don't need that spiraling pathway anymore. You're free to exuberate into all of the reality around you and to be that. That is your pathway from there, see? So it goes on forever, even though that seems like a completing point symbolically now. But it goes on forever and takes you everywhere with it, you see? Just a quiet little moment, you and me and the rest of this family, uniting symbolically with the whole fullness of the reality, the real presence of life. And continuing that journey in something even more of a spiraling way that's based on the energy that we feel and the blessing that we deal into the life that makes it real. See, we give up. We got our roots in the 3D and in the basis of that ever-ascending reality, and then we take it multidimensionally. So we don't need the path of the 3D any longer, you know. That's part of us now. That's where our root is, in the feeling of the personal experience in 3D. But now that becomes personal for everybody and everything. And all begin to experience a person within themselves as well. Because the human babies, as the children of the universe, were willing to go through all of this just for that one uniting moment where it all comes together in completeness as we emote forth from the mother of creation. And again, that's the beginning right there, baby. That's the end of living and dying. That's life everlasting, going on forever. But just a quiet little moment, a fun little moment of love here on a Valentine's Day when we go there in a celebratory way, man. So each of us does it in our own funny way today. And you'll see yourself going through it even if you don't plan for it, man. It just come your way, you know. Because that's what we're here for, man. It's like, you know, Valentine's is joining the heart, joining with the heart, becoming the completeness of the heart, which is the mother love in creation. That's the heart of creation, is the mother love. And the end of your agony is when you realize the mother love presence inside of yourself. That's when the pain goes away, brothers and sisters. That's when the life comes out to play. Perhaps you'll have that moment today as we share it with you. In this coyote sort of way from all these high little places here in the lower realms of reality, man. Isn't it awesome? I just like the ironic pleasure in it all, man. You know, the ironic truth, which is so powerful and so loving and so real and so right. See, that's all it takes to get wings and take flight. Here's to you, my darling, too. All of us. Together in this one, the one life of love, living in celebration, man. That's creation, darlings. And the original moment of creation, right here at Spring Creek, the headwaters of love, only and exclusively on the Hazy Radio Network, your center of rock and roll paradise, you know. Now listen to Reuben James. He'll tell you how to get it just right, man. He's lived a life that, well, filled with strife, but got it right. Yep, I'm telling you, babies, you just can't get enough of this kind of love. Yeah, right here at Spring Creek, the headwaters of life, the very source of the medicine of your life. Ooh, that helps you resolve everything that ever came out as strife or stress or something that made you want to get undressed. We're fully clothed here on the Hazy Radio Network and seeing it real clear, dear. And therefore, fully protected and not infected by what? That kind of love. No, no, no. We got this kind of love, which is what? That kind of love in this form, baby. It's Spring Creek. You know, it's a medicine show too, man. The headwaters of life. The water just flows through you, man. The original water, man. You just take that one little sip and everything starts to come clear and the life starts to rise forward inside you, dear, as it never has before. Because before, you didn't even know you was alive, man. You had to come to these headwaters of life to find this kind of love, baby. Right here coming through, Grandpa Coyote, I would say. I mean, that too, man. But, baby, you can have it your way. Each and every day, right here, Monday through Friday, with Grandpa Coyote and a whole raft of coyote and ancestral and angelic friends, man, coming from all over the universe, man, and helping you to tune in to what you know is right. Right there inside your soft, sweet little hide, on your soft, sweet little heart, you take a soft, sweet little ride, and baby, it's rock and it's roll. But it's not hardness, don't you know? It's the softness of love, getting in the flow. flow, man. Oh, baby, we keep that flow going, too. In a united sort of way, we join our hearts. And we do convey our precious energy right now, today, again, to that sweet dam over there on the Feather River called the Oroville Dam there in California. And we bless and protect the people down below there, wouldn't you say? And we help everybody get it fixed and let the water hold back for just a little while longer, please, because our friends in Sacramento and Oakland and everywhere else that would be affected by that gotta be okay right now here today. Yeah, I told you Oakland would be, I mean, the whole, you don't, that dam goes, it's gonna be some major damage all over that middle northern part of California, man, I'm telling you. So this is why we send our love right there, right now, too, babies, because we are the love that holds it together, that keeps this creation going despite all of its imperfections and infections and genuflections and all of that shit too, man. It didn't genuflect enough, now did it? But we do. We genuflect to that heart all the time. What does that mean, Grandpa? What are you talking about, genuflect? Man, what's that? You smoke that shit or what? Well, sometimes, but mostly genuflect means you, you know, politely curtsy and, you know, tip your hat to the course of the ladies and the gentlemen's going by in case they might be respectable people. You never know. You know, this is what you do, man, because, you know, better to be safe than sorry. Don't take a chance in this militarized world. They might take you to a concentration camp and call you a vamp and never let you go, man. Put you in torment and slave labor, don't you know, down under the ground where there ain't no snow, ain't no rain, ain't no sun, and it ain't no fun. Yeah, we know. They do have secret underground facilities, don't you know? But so far, we've kept them out of that business, ain't we, baby? And we're going to keep them out of their business, too, man. In fact, we're exposing all the monkey business in D.C. and New York City and Los Angeles, California, etc., man. It's part of that unified heart, man. The more we gather together, the more we convey our strength of heart into this reality, the more other people begin to see and the less they can lie to anybody. Oh, it's a wicked little revolution, and it's so much fun. You don't even need a gun or ammunition either, nor silver nor gold. Just be what you are, man, and don't do what you're told. I mean, it's real simple, man. Just, you know, when they tell you go this way, you go that. When they say jump, you go no. You lay down and go to sleep when they say jump, don't you know? Oh, baby, not quite as bad as all that, but almost, you know. You got to show them who's real and who's right, so they'll give up the ghost of unfriendliness and cruelty and pain and shit, you know, and get on with it. Because you got to understand now, honest to goodness, I mean, I don't care who it is, the most wicked ruler in the whole world, the most awful CEO there ever could be, Adolf Hitler and his mother too. We're all in it together, babies. You know, and these people, as wicked as they are there just to tempt you into holding severe judgment and making war on them and seeing where that takes you. So you'll get over it and stop doing that kind of shit, and they can stop being ugly, because when we're not reacting to it anymore, well, the fuel goes from the fire, man, and it's just no fun. You know, if people don't respond and, you know, pain and horror and great revulsion, you know, then these pigs are doing piggy things, and we see them plain as day, and they can't get away with it anymore. In fact, like I say, we just take the fuel out of the fire. It ain't no fun if people ain't horrified. You know, if you ain't making people sick out there, well, guess what? You're making them better, including your own self, see? See how the revolution works? It's so quiet and so simple, but so powerful, baby. And it ain't the brain, no, it's the strain that brings forward the heart into the brain. So you got to unify the mind in a conscious presence called the heart, and the soul, of course, which is an extension of spirit, man. Now, do you want me to explain the whole doggone thing, or should we just rock and roll and not worry about how the medicine flow? Just flow with it, don't you know? See, that's the way we do, man. You know, details get in the way. We've had wars over those before when, you know, nobody even knew what would be the details, man. We were creating them as we went along, and the details was war. Isn't that stupid? And now we got this little group of people over there, and this little group of people over there, and this little group of people over there that think the whole world will hate them, and they want to blow up the whole world and then show them how powerful they are, because we'll never get taken down again. And they're out there using this as an excuse to kill women and children. And, you know, in our own damn country, not only backs it up and supports it, goes and drop bombs for them, man. We make war for our friends. It's kind of stupid, wouldn't you say? And they're really not friends. They're just taking advantage of you. Who do you think was, well, a big chunk of 911 in the background, of course, you know. Now, do your research. I'm just telling you what I've seen here and there, so it's an opinion, man. So don't blame me, you know. I mean, but if you want to set yourself free, you got to see through such shit as that. You know what I mean? And don't be reactive, you know. And you know, I mean, darlings, pay attention to what your own eyes, your own heart are telling you. Pay attention to what's going on in the so-called background, because that's the foreground where everything's made, everything's created. Back there in that secret place where it can't be secret no more. If you go back there in your own secret place, which ain't secret then, is it, man? Because it's shared everywhere. With everyone. See, the more you expand in the heart's presence, the more your mind and heart join together. In a divine union, by the way, that's real creative, like making love, you know. And it brings forward a baby, too, man. The one you were born to be, and always have been, and always will be. The one that's been hiding out there inside of you, you know. Yeah, that's what we're here for, man. You get this cool drink of water here at Spring Creek, the headwaters of life. Next thing you know, you're taking that little stroll called life, and you're feeling it. And you're dealing with it in a whole new way because you're creating it and they can't hide nothing from you, baby. In your innocence, you see right through all of it, too. And you recreate it as you go, so everything is like a nice, smooth, even flow. Even that goddamn dam down there that wants to blow. Don't you know? That's how powerful we each is, man. One at a time and all of us together united in the divine, which is one at a time, okay? I know it gets a little confusing along the way, so here, let me help you straighten out your conscious presence. I'll share a little sacred toke with you, and this one will be quite enlightening, you see? Okay, here we go. You get an adventure here. Every time, don't you know, at Spring Creek, the headwaters of life, here on the Hazy Radio Network with Grandpa Coyote and friends. Yes, indeedy, we share ourselves expansively. In ways you can't even begin to comprehend until you feel it. And then you know it's real. And that's the deal, right? See, that's unity heart. When I can do an experience here and share the experience with you, that's unity heart, baby. That's us starting to recognize our collective motion. The wave in motion. It goes through life all the time, man. You know, I call it a tsunami of love now because that's what it is. But it's been in different kinds of waves and been chopping and chooping and, you know, knocking us every which way. No wonder we've been acting like a bunch of sea-drunk sailors, man. Enough of getting whipped this way and that. Now we go with the flow, man. Instead of letting it rock and roll, we just rock and roll with the flow, man. Because that's what it is, rock and roll. The veritable medicine for your heart and soul, which is understanding it, don't you know? The music sets you up, and then your mind gets in the flow. Your heart softens you up, and then you go into creation, don't you know? Flow. Your old feelings out there instead of in here. No, they're still in here too, man. What's out there is in here, and in here's out there. And it all feels so, expansive, don't you know? See, it's still Mardi Gras. We could still party. You know, yesterday was Let's Go Make Love Day. Today is Mardi Gras. Says, wow, let's do some more of that shit, huh? See what else kind of mischief we can get into, too, man. I mean, you know, that's only good for what? An hour or two or 22? Depends on who you are and where you're at and how well you are engaged. Every truck shits a little differently, man. Every car steers a little strangely, man. Each one of them have their own little personality. Well, human beings being much the same way. And there's no predicting what will go when the flow begins to happen naturally. Because you're going to do it differently than the dude or dudette next to you and so on and so forth. But yet we're all united in that effort. Each of us doing it uniquely, personally, individually. And you know, with liberty and justice for all and that shit too, you know, right now. Oh, I know the Statue of Liberty's been hanging her head in shame and I don't blame her, man. You know, it's like we've been infected in the brain, just like I was with skin cancer a while back. Well, sometimes when it's there, you just got to cut it out and go on, man. You know, well, darlings, we're kind of up to that, but in a real softer sort of way here in this reality. We're taking the concept of infection away. The very idea that there could be anything wrong with any one of us, you see. That's what I'm talking about when I'm talking about undoing the likes of Adolf Hitler and Dick Cheney, which are one and the same. Did you recognize that? Yeah, I tell you, well, Cheney's a test tube baby, so they kind of made him from the... Well, yeah, the fertility of Hitler, okay? I mean, you know, shit, he couldn't help it, and Hitler couldn't help it either if they took his stuff and froze it, man. I mean, you know, shit. I mean, you know, the wickedness wanted to continue itself as long as it possibly could because it was having such a great time here, you know what I mean? Tormenting these poor little innocent souls. And oh, man, I tell you, it's just really sad the kind of shit's gone on, ain't it? But the sacrifices made by the human heart to disprove that very foul nature of the other, man, you see? And it's worked. The foul nature's, you know, gone off for the last time, man. Do you believe that inside yourself? It's true. And if that's true in you, guess what? It happens outside too. This is how we change the world. This is how we bring ourselves back from the Nazi reality that has taken over here. We be honest about it when we see it. And it's more than just a bunch of Nazis. And there are a bunch of sick slime dogs in the background. They make the Nazis look freaking innocent in a way. You know what I mean? But, you know, again, you got to be really careful not to get pulled in to that, you know, judgmental place, you know, where you're saying, ah, arrow, ooh, fight, fight, fight. No, no. Right, right, right. Get it right inside. See, nothing but love in everything. Yourself first and foremost. And then that's all you're going to see outside yourself. And those beings and forms and figurements just don't exist anymore. They're totally and completely transformed right now by what's going on inside of you. See, the secret is you. You're the center of it all, the same way the Mother Earth is the center of it all. And I don't give a shit what these other mofos say, man. Scientists that say we're some obscure little planet with, you know, a bunch of chimpanzees. These are the Pleiadians came and made something out of. Oh, horse shit. This is universal creation, man. We are the baby children of life. You know, you're starting to feel that, starting to know what that really is. You know, that's why I call us babies all the time. Doesn't mean, you know, you're just laying there shitting diapers and being miserable. No, it means you're back to that innocent flow that just knows it's got to be here again, don't you know? Don't know why, you know, but when it gets out here, it's like, whoa, man, what a vision. And they smack you on the fanny or scrub you down with a brush or something and get you suffering like everybody else and knock you right out of yourself, see? But this is all about coming back into yourself. See, every shocking experience we have after our birth and that first trauma that takes it away from us, which everybody goes through, I don't care how loving the people around you are, it's part of the program here and it'll happen despite the sincerity of others around you. Same way, you don't mean to get pissed off at anybody, but sometimes you do, right? See, it's not natural to you, yet it happens. See, that's what happens to the babies, too. The most sincere people are still a little out of control here, and they still, you know, convey the energies of the nastiness, the abject cruelty, the trauma, in other words, that knocks you out of your body, takes away your true spiritual moments, your true spiritual heart, and you spend the rest of your life, if you're lucky, getting it back. If you're not lucky, well, you're knocked out for the rest of your life. And then you wonder why there's zombies all around you and why you feel like a zombie too. Because they knocked the shit out of you when you were a tiny little kid. Even though they didn't mean to, you know. It happens to everybody. And then every trauma after that, depending on the degree and severity of it, you know, repeats that experience. See, I've just been through another, so I'm remembering all this stuff and reassembling it for you so we can reassemble our lives and get beyond it too. See what I mean? When you remember how that all happens and that it really is something that happens to you right there at the beginning of life and it's just part of the rules and regulations to coming in here as a spiritual person, a spiritual being, you know, it's just part of what we have to sign up for. You know? But being the brave little pioneer angels we are, we'll do that. You know, we'll do that. Lots of us, you know, we have done, you know. So now it's time to step out in the sun, get out of the cave. Don't be a slave, in other words. What does that mean? Let the feelings take you forward. The deeper, more power. The ones you're feeling right now that we're sharing with you here from 9,000 feet high in the Rocky Mountain sky. That drink of water, you know, that spring creek, the original water of life. It gives you that beginning. Takes you from the beginning right through back all of life again. And you begin to understand every bit of it, which means you're expanding into the multidimensional presence, because that's where the understanding is. It cannot be understood in the 3D. But expansively, of course, it all starts to make sense then. And it all becomes the great age of peace, the arrival of the blue star inside of each and every heart that lives, the return of the sun into the mother as one, and no longer the polarity of division. Babies, it's the revision, the truth coming forward, the dreamers who are the glow of the sun and the mother together, dreaming this dream of separation no more. Waking up, see, that's how we even the score. That's how we get it on. See, what a revolution really is, man. Now, here's the solution, too. You know, we got this crazy, insane, well, reflection of our own heart back there in D.C. trying to run things, you know. Let's make him the marijuana president. Let's him make him not only the one that, you know, makes marijuana legal all across this country, but takes the pressure off all the countries around this world that, you know, the U.S. is more or less forced to, through coercion, to illegalize the pot there too, man. Let's get weed legal everywhere. Let's make Mr. Rumpo back there the one that does it, okay? You know, instead of chewing gummy, smokes a great big old spliff at the beginning of each day and sets an example for the children of America, because he don't just lay there on the couch and watch TV. No, he gets up and makes big pronouncements and, you know, and gets over the insanity, and all of a sudden he's speaking from the heart and, you know, designing things as a living work of art and no longer listening to the greedy, butt-headed sons of bitches like he's been forever. I mean, you know, this is transformation. Unity of heart can make such things real, and it can happen right now. That's the deal. If you wanted to. If you're ready to let go of the judgment. It's the same way, like, I've been watching myself, you know, my own inclinations inside of myself and what goes on here. Ooh, it ain't always really what it ought to be now, should it? You see, and when we start seeing this disaster building up there in California and that dam going to break, there's a part of me that says, yeah, let it break. I want to see all that destruction. You know, we don't want to see anybody get killed, but we want to see it go down. You know, it doesn't like the phony presence that the dam represents, you know, and the holding back of the rivers. I mean, it wants that thing destroyed. But it's a little part of me, you know. And it knows better. It's just entertained by such thinking. Well, in such thinking, you can actually create such a thought into being. You know, a lot of us get in trouble that way because we don't pay attention. We hear nasty, nasty little thoughts like that inside ourselves. We say no, and we shut it off. You know, only it don't shut off. It's an energy, it's a flow, you know, and it's going to go, go, go until you embrace it, yeah. And say, no, no, no. Well, you just understand. I mean, you know, a child that's had, you know how it is, because each of us have done this, some more than others, but there is a certain rebellion that comes with getting the shit kicked out of you and get the life knocked out of you when you're a tiny little baby child. And you start to fight back, age 2, 3 to 5. You start to fight back in your own little baby-like way, you know, and you don't even know you're doing it. It's primal. It's, you know, intrinsic. It's automatic pilot. It's what happens when you're traumatized, man, out of your person. You know, so we all know the way back too, but it's like, wow, you know, because we've been fighting our way back ever since then, man, you know, since we were tiny little babies. And I don't care, the most zombified person here, at the base core of every desire you have is a pure desire to be returned to that natural state of being that you felt for a moment in time when you first assimilated into the human heart as a tiny, tiny, tiny little specter of a baby child, emoted from your mother's body one way or another. When you took that first breath, before they took your breath away, forever and ever, it seems. But no, 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 the dam's not breaking. Hey, baby, we're getting it together. And even if it does, it's not. It's going to go real slow. If it does break, now it's going to, because we've got our heart energy in that. Only a few of us, you know, maybe a few hundred of us around the world, that's all it takes, you know, because that hundreds is joined by thousands, joined by millions. It really is. And we all start to recognize the pure heart inside which does not want the destruction, which wants everybody to find the way to be happy, to be able to live in peace and joy and not be threatened or endangered by anything, your neighbors or the big dam down the street or whatever. You know, the truck drivers going up and down a highway, whatever, you know, bank robbers, whatever, never to be threatened again by anything. But to know that it's always going to be not only in a peaceful flow, but a happily expansive one, like, you know, the river is active. It doesn't just flow. It wiggles around a whole bunch and, you know, journeys here and journeys there. And sometimes, you know, it jumps its banks and makes a whole new channel go in that direction. You know what I mean? And you got to give the river its heart. You got to give it its flow. See, this is where dams get in the way, man. This is why we have trouble with them every now and then. It's telling us, no, take these things away. And if you're going to do it the way nature does, you know, with smaller and smaller. And, you know, you can pipe from the top one down to the bottom one, et cetera, and still get your hydro and, you know, your flood control and all that shit. It's just a matter of design, you know, and of being, well, you know what we do? We leave it up to nature. We keep moving in this direction. Then we don't need the flow of electricity no more because we're in the flow of creation. That's power. Real power. And it's not driven by polarity. It's driven by union, which is the understanding of the togetherness of all life, which brings a cosmic moment I call the big O, which is expansion in creation. And it ain't nothing like you've known before, yet there's a familiarity in all of it, don't you know? It's what your heart's craving for right now. I feel it, because I'm in the flow with you, don't you know? See, that's unity heart. That's the real collective of humanity moving together to bring the best possible outcome for everyone. And that's our living in love and truth here this day at the headwaters of life, Spring Creek, from 9,000 feet high in the Rocky Mountain sky. You got that rock and roll kind of guy who likes to take off and fly with you, of course. I'm just not much fun alone, but sometimes being that lone eagle can be really cool too, let me tell you. I like being in the air, don't you? The higher the better, man, you know. Ooh, yeah. Salute, my babies. May today be your paradise day. The return of it all in a Mardi Gras sort of way. You know, party down. Get out there and play, okay?